So far, we have discussed about introduction to GST, features of GST, and the registration process under GST. In this module, we will discuss about the types of returns to be filed under GST and the procedure and the requirements for filing the GST returns. GST returns. All the GST returns will have to be filed from one single common portal of GSTIN. This will help in tracking all the types of return filing from one single platform, unlike the current tax regime. Under GST, tax return filing has been divided into different categories as per the kind of business they do. So who are the people who are required to file the returns? First and the foremost are the normal registered taxpayers, tax deductors, input service distributors, non-resident taxable persons, composite suppliers, e-commerce operators, and persons making interstate taxable supplies. All these people are eligible to file GST returns. Let us now look at which return needs to be filed by whom and on what date. So first return is GST return 1. This return is for outward supplies, that is sales. This is due by 10th of the next month and it is to be filed by all the regular taxpayers and casual and non-resident taxpayers. Next is GST return 2. This is the return for inward supplies, that is purchases, and it is due by 15th of the next month. This again is due to be filed by all the taxpayers and casual and non-resident taxpayers. Next is the monthly return to be filed based on the finalization of outward and inward supplies. This has to be filed by 20th of the next month and it has to be filed by all the regular taxpayers and casual and non-resident taxpayers. Next is a quarterly return, which is GST return 4, to be filed by the SSEs who have opted for composition scheme. This return is due by 18th of the next quarter. Next is GST return 5. This return is for non-resident foreign taxable persons. It is due by 20th of the next month. Next is GST return 5. This return is to be filed by the input service distributors. It is due by 13th of the next month and it is to be filed by the input service distributors. Next is GST return 7. This return is to be filed by the SSEs who are deducting tax at source. It is to be filed by 10th of the next month. Next is GST return 8. This return is to be filed by SSEs collecting tax at source. This is also to be filed by 10th of the next month. So e-commerce service operators are the classic examples of people who are required to file this return. Next is GST return 9. This is the annual return and it is due by 31st of December of the next financial year. This has to be filed by all the regular taxpayers. Next is GST return 10, which is final return. This return is to be filed within 3 months of the date of cancellation or date of cancellation order, whichever is later. It is to be filed by dealers whose license is cancelled or surrendered. And lastly, GST return 11. This is the returns to be filed by the persons having UIN. It is a return for inward supply and it is due by 28th of the month following the month for which the statement is filed. In the previous slide, we saw the different types of returns to be filed by different categories of people and the due dates of the same. With that in mind, we can see that a regular dealer has to file in total 4 returns. First one is GST return 1, which is the monthly sales details, GST return 2, which is the monthly purchase details, GST return 3, which is the monthly final filing and tax payment, and finally the annual tax return, which is the GST return 9. All the 4 returns have to be filed by each of the registered regular dealer. Now let us see what are the important details that needs to be furnished for each of the return in order to have a timely filing of return without any error. Let us start with GST return 1. So quickly to recap, this return is for outward supplies and it is due by 10th of the following month, which means if the return is to be filed for July 2017, the due date would be 10th of August 2017. In this return, all your sales invoices needs to be uploaded on the GST portal. All the transactions post implementation needs to be classified as HSN and SSE code. HSN is the harmonized system of nomenclature used for goods, and SSE is the services accounting code used for services. All the interstate transactions of more than ₹2,50,000 also needs to be declared in GST return 1. Apart from the above, GST return will contain following important and basic information. It would contain basic details of the taxpayer along with name and the GST IN number. It will contain details of the period to which the return pertains. It will also contain details of the taxable outward supply to a registered person and taxable outward interstate supplies to a consumer, an invoice value of more than 2.5 lakh. It would also contain details of taxable outward supplies to consumers other than the cases mentioned above. Apart from this, it would also contain details of debit and credit notes. It would then include details of amendments of outward supplies pertaining to earlier tax periods. Outward supplies can be categorized into nil rated, exempted and non-GST outward supplies. Supplies exported including deemed exports also needs to be declared in this return. Tax liability of the amount received in advance against a supply to be made in future also needs to be declared in this return. Details of taxes already paid on invoices issued in the current period needs to be keyed in. Outward supply details needs to be communicated to the registered taxable person by updating the input tax credit ledger. It is noteworthy that supplies underreported to the extent of 5% will be blacklisted under the compliance rating system of GST. Any amendment which requires to be done cannot be done through GST return 1, but it has to be done under a separate column provided in GST return 3. This simply means that once the GST return 1 is filed, you cannot make any amendment to this return. You can do the amendments or adjustments at the time of filing the monthly returns in your GST return 3 form. Next is GST return 2. This return is return for inward supplies. As we saw earlier, this return is due by 15th of the next month. So for example, if the return is to be filed for July 2017, this return is due by August 15, 2017. GST Return 2 is an auto-populated return in the GST e-filing system. The details and figures in this return are auto-populated based on the details filled in GST Return 1 by its counterparts. The information furnished for this return are basic details of the taxpayer along with the GST IN number, period to which the return pertains, details of inward supplies and purchases received from registered taxpayers, details of goods and capital goods received from overseas, that is import of goods. Similarly, details of services received from a supplier located outside India, that is import of services, details of debit and credit notes, amendments to details of inward supplies received in earlier tax periods. This would also include post-purchase discounts which are received. Next is the details of supplies received from compounding or unregistered dealers and other exempt NIL or non-GST supplies. Credit received in the form of input service distributors, TDS and input tax credit. After 11th day of the succeeding month, the service receiver can view their input tax credit ledger on the GST IN network. Addition or deletion of the invoice by the taxpayer will be permitted between 12th and 15th of the succeeding month, and any adjustments would be permitted on 16th and 17th of the succeeding months to this return. In the previous slides, we discussed GST Return 1 and GST Return 2. We now move on to discuss GST Return 3, which is a monthly return to be filed based on the finalization of outward and inward supplies. This return is due by 20th of the next month. This means return for the month of July 2017 will be due to be filed by 20th of August 2017. As mentioned, it is a monthly return and payment needs to be made as per the detail furnished in GST Return 1 and GST Return 2. All the details mentioned in this return are pre-populated based on the GST Return 1 and GST Return 2 filed already. Separate cash ledgers needs to be maintained for CGST, SGST and IGST. Registered taxable person shall not be allowed to furnish return for a period if the return for any previous period has not been furnished by him. Details of input tax credit ledger, cash ledger and liability ledger would be updated on the back end on a real-time basis. It is to be noted that any omission or incorrect particulars found after filing of GST Return 3 can be rectified in the return of the month during which such omission is discovered. However, the payment of interest should be made along with the corrections. No rectification would be allowed after due date for filing of the return for the month of September following the end of the financial year, or actual date of filing of annual return, whichever is earlier. GST Return 3 would also include details like other returns, which is like basic details of taxpayer, that is name along with the GST IN number, period to which the return pertains, details of monthly outward supply, details of monthly inward supply, including details of inward reverse charge mechanism, import, intrastate and interstate supplies, total tax liability for the month including liability under reverse charge, and the net input tax credit available. So far we discussed GST Return 1, GST Return 2 and GST Return 3. These are the three important returns which are to be filed by regular dealers on a periodic basis. Now we move on to discuss the special categories of returns, that is GST return 4. This return is to be filed by a person opting the composition scheme. This return is due by 18th of the next quarter, which means the return to be filed for the quarter ended June 2017 would be due by 18th of July 2017. Now before we move on to discuss the details of GST return 4, let us understand what do you mean by composite dealers. Composite dealers are the dealers who calculate GST payable by paying output GST at a lower rate, and they will not claim input tax credit. So what are the basic information that needs to be keyed into the return? It will include details like the total value of supply made during the period of return, details of payment of tax. They have to declare invoice level purchase information and the details of goods and services imported from outside India. Let us now discuss GST return 5. GST return 5 is to be filed by a non-resident foreign taxable person. This return is due by 20th of the following month, which means return for the month of July 2017 would be due to be filed by 20th of August 2017. So as mentioned, every registered non-resident taxable person is required to furnish a GST return 5 electronically through the common portal. GST return 5 requires business details of non-resident, including the details of outward supplies and inward supplies. Like any other return, it includes details like basic details of the taxpayer, that is name along with the GST TIN number, period to which the return pertains, details of imports, details of outward supplies, details of input tax credit available, details of taxes paid, details of monthly return, and finally the details of closing stock. Next is GST return 6. This return needs to be filed by the input service distributors. This return is due by 13th of the next month. This means that the return for the month of July 2017 would be due to be filed by 13th of August 2017. So before we move on to discuss what are the details of GST return 6, let us understand what do you mean by input service distributor. Input service distributor under GST model includes an office of the supplier of goods and services which receives tax invoice issued by supplier towards receipt of input services and issues a prescribed document for the purpose of distributing the credit of CGST, SGST or IGST paid on the said service. The return of GST filed by input service distributors would contain information like basic details of the taxpayer along with the GST TIN number, period to which the return pertains, details of inward supplies made available to the input service distributor recipient on the basis of form GST return 1 and GST return 5, details of the invoices along with the GST TIN of the receiver of the credit, that is to whom the input service distributor is distributing the credit. Input service distributor ledger contains ISD or input service distributor ledger would contain details like opening balance of the input tax credit, credit for ITC services received, debit for ITC reversal and ITC distributed, and finally the closing balance. Next is GST return 7. This return is to be filed by the persons who are liable to deduct tax at source. This return is due by 10th of the next month. This means that return for the month of July 2017 would be due to be filed by 10th of August 2017. So as mentioned before, TDS is to be deducted at the rate of 1% on the payments made to the supplier of taxable goods or services, where the total value of such supply under an individual contract exceeds ₹2,50,000. People like local authorities, government agencies, or a departmental or establishment of the central or state government are liable to deduct TDS. Return form for TDS is almost similar to the TDS return of the Income Tax Act, that is Form 26Q and 24Q. Return would contain information like basic details of the taxpayer, that is name along with the GST TIN number, period to which the return pertains, details of GST TIN of the supplier along with the invoices against which the TDS has been deducted, details of tax deducted against each major head, that is CGST, SGST and IGST, and finally details of payments like interest, penalties, fees, etc. Next is GST Return 8. This return needs to be filed by the person who is liable to collect tax at source, like the e-commerce service operators. This return is due by 10th of the next month. For example, return for the month of July 2017 would be due to be filed by 10th of August 2017. Mostly, as mentioned before, e-commerce operators are liable to collect tax at source and they are liable to file this return. Return would contain information like details of the supplies to registered taxable person made through the e-commerce operator. Any amendment to the details of the supplies to registered taxable person made through the e-commerce operator. It would also contain details of the supplies to unregistered person made through the e-commerce operator. It would also contain details of tax collected at source and the details of liability payable and the liability actually paid. Next we discuss is GST Return 9. This return is the annual return which is to be filed by all the regular taxpayers. This return is due by 31st December of the next financial year. For instance, the annual return for the financial year ended 2016 would be due to be filed by 31st December 2017. Similarly, GST return 9A would be required to be filed by composition dealer as the annual return. The law also states that any registered taxable person whose turnover is greater than 1 crore would be required to file his audited accounts along with a reconciliation statement duly certified by a chartered accountant in the form GST Return 9B. This needs to be submitted electronically through the common e-portal. Intention of this return is to give a 360 degree view about the activities of the taxpayer. This return provides a reconciliation of the returns with the audited financial statements of the taxpayer. It captures the details of all the income and expenditure of the taxpayer and regroups them in accordance with the monthly returns filed by the taxpayer. It also contains details of gross profit or loss arrived on the basis of the details submitted in this return, and this should tally with the gross profit and loss account indicated in the profit and loss account of the dealer. As mentioned before, return is to be submitted along with the audited copies of the annual accounts. Reconciliation statement and copy of audited books of accounts duly certified by a chartered accountant needs to be filed by taxpayers having aggregate turnover of rupees more than 1 crore. Return should contain details like total value of purchases on which the input tax credit has been availed for interstate, intrastate and imports. Details of other purchases on which no input tax credit has been availed. Details of sales returns. Details of other expenditures, that is expenditures other than purchases. Details of income, that is total value of supply on which GST is paid under intrastate supply, interstate supply and exports. Similarly, total value of supplies on which no GST has been paid. Value of other supplies on which no GST has been paid. Details of purchase returns. Other income. Return would also contain details like arrears based on the audits and assessments, refunds, as well as it will include details of profits as per the profit and loss account. It would include details of gross profit, profit after tax and net profit. Next is GST return 10. This is the final return which needs to be filed by the dealers whose registration has been cancelled or surrendered. This return is due to be filed within 3 months of the date of cancellation or date of cancellation order, whichever is later. This return would contain details like details of input and capital goods held and the details of taxes payable and taxes actually paid. Last but not the least, we will discuss about GST return 11. GST return 11 is to be filed by the government department and the union nation bodies. Such people are issued a unique identity number under GST and they are required to file GST return 11, which is due by 28th of the month following the month for which the statement is filed. For instance, details for the month of July 2017 would be due to be filed by 28th of August 2017. This would contain details like inward supplies as well as details of purchase and consumption which is made by the United Nations bodies or the government departments. With this, we end our module on GST returns. In the next module, we will talk about valuation of supply, that is how to value the supply of goods or services.